seat. We'll get started. I would like to take this opportunity to welcome everybody here to the 5th annual Mustang Club of Medford Scholarship Banquet. 5 years ago, a group of gentlemen had a vision of a plan to put together an organization similar to the E-Club in Everett and the Touchdown Club of Arlington that took care of the youth and youth sports in the city of Medford. And since that original meeting 5 years ago, we have grown, we have done some things that we'll talk about a little bit later on. At this time, I'd like to introduce this year's president, to welcome you, Mr. Stan Gomez.
Thank you, Mark. I'd like to welcome everyone here to the 5th annual Mustang Club Banquet. This year, we're going to award 4 scholarships. 2 additional scholarships be awarded in the name of Michael Patterson. I'd like to welcome new and returning members to the Mustang Club. As we end our 5th year, the Mustang Club will continue to bring our student athletes of Medford all the support they rightfully deserve. I encourage you to join our team. This year, the Mustang Club recently presented over 80 plaques to the graduating seniors at the M Club Banquet. We had our 2nd annual comedy night at Montfair Plaza, which was a huge success. We also had an alumni soccer game for boys and girls, alumni football, as well as an alumni baseball game. Over the past 5 years, the Mustang Club has given away almost $10,000 to all sport programs in the city. I'd like to thank the officers and members for their support and look forward to working with the new administration. Now I'd like to turn over the program to the Master of Ceremonies, Mark Smith.
I do want to acknowledge those other officers that Stan talked about, Vice President Carlson Gotti. The awards chairperson, Bill Tarsenia. And the membership chairperson, Bill Tar Jr. Everybody can please rise for grace. Bless the school we're about to eat. For the parents, coaches, teachers, and all adults present, may they continue to accept their job as role models for the youngsters in our community. For the scholarship winners who are about to move on to a new adventure, may they continue to make good decisions and uphold the standards expected of them. Amen. There are a couple of people in the audience tonight I'd like to recognize. Representing the Medford City Council, Mr. Jay Keating. And Mr. Paul Donato. From the Medford School Committee, Mr. Bob Sherry. There is a senior scholarship night going on at the high school at this time. We do have, representing the high school administration, submasters Dave Pocari and Rosemary Trainer. The athletic director of Medford High School, Mr. Bud Kelly. Another great job tonight with the meal, one of our founding fathers, Marty's Caterers, Mr. Marty Murphy. Some of the Mustang Club events that will be happening. The next one we have scheduled on Sunday, June 11th, in Medford Square is the Clippership Day. And the Mustang Club mans a table that day with a dunk tank. We're looking for some volunteers. There's one walking in the door, I'm sure he'll volunteer. Falcon Party is looking for volunteers for the dunk tank. Next fall, Billy Carr is in the process of putting together another alumni day. Last year we had 150 alumni come back to Playstead Park. This year, we're going to do it up bigger and better with the boys and girls soccer games, a touch football game, and a baseball game all going on down at Playstead Park in September. The first Saturday in March next year up at Montvale Plaza will be our third annual comedy night. The money we generate from the comedy night pays for the scholarships we give out at this banquet. Another announcement, some of you probably haven't heard, hasn't hit the paper yet, but combined with Monday's victory over Arlington, 5-0, and yesterday's 10-inning PB win over Everett, Coach Manitow and the boys' baseball team and GBL co-champs this season.
Thank you, Coach Smith. First of all, let me congratulate all of the award winners, scholarship recipients this evening for a job well done and for your marvelous tenure at Medford High School and what you've contributed to the community. And let me thank all of you for the great job that you have done in helping to make the Mustang Club a thriving organization that gives opportunities to the youngsters throughout this community. You know, when a group got together a few years ago, people wondered whether or not they could survive and keep a group together to actually come and support athletics at Medford High. And I think as you see the turnout here today, I don't know, Marty, how many years later? 4 or 5 years later, you're still here, you're still strong, you're doing a great job, and we're very appreciative for what you do for the student athletes at Medford High School. You know, I've said on many occasions that for many student athletes, the difference between a college education and not is the scholarship money that they get, whether it's some here, some that they receive at the M Club banquet, or through the very many businesses in our community that contribute and help children to go on and student athletes to live a better quality of life. And for all of you who are here and have done such a good job, I congratulate you. To Andrew Pallotta, I congratulate you on the selection of your guest speaker this evening, a gentleman who has brought great credit to his hometown of Medford, not only throughout the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, but throughout the United States of America, and the fine reputation that he put together out at Indiana University, not only as a student, but as an athlete. Have a good evening, congratulations, and good luck to everybody. At this time, it gives me a great deal of pleasure to be able to introduce somebody who was a former teammate of mine at Medford High School. No, I wasn't on the swim team, but he was on the football team with me when I was back at Medford High School. And I've been talking to his high school coach, Mr. Lennon, the last couple of days. He's given me a little bit of information. He was one of those athletes, those swimmers who always get the preferential treatment at Medford High School. I found out he never had to go to homeroom when he was at Medford High School. He had a submaster, Mr. Maskell, who put him on the bulletin every day, not absent, not tardy, because he was doing his swimming and diving before school. He was practicing from 6 o'clock to 8 o'clock every morning before school, and then he'd run right to first period. Coach Lennon remembers him as always loyal to his team and his school. The only time he'd get mad was when, after he'd be swimming a couple of laps, Coach Lennon would stop and call everybody over and tell a joke, and he'd already have the punchline out, and he'd be just pulling up, last one into the over to the edge of the pool, and he'd always miss the joke, and he always got mad at Mr. Lennon for that. But his accomplishments, which are listed in the book, are unbelievable. Eastern Mass Diving Champion. State Diving Champion, New England Diving Champion. All Scholastic, Boston Globe and Boston Herald, his junior and senior year. And he's one of the very, very few Medford High School athletes who was named an All-American in the sport twice. He went on to that great swimming school before Bobby Knight took over, the University of Indiana. And he won 3 Big Ten Diving Championships, the NCAA Division I National Diving Team 2 years. And when it was all done, he came back home to God's country. Even though he lives in Andover, he owns a printing business in Medford, and he was helped start the Mustang Club, and is what Mustang Pride is all about. Our guest speaker, Mr. Andy Pallotta. I wish I won a Big Ten championship. I was on a Big Ten championship team. It's an honor to be here. So many familiar faces, it's an honor to be here tonight. I'd like to thank the Mustang Club for having me as the speaker. Looking at the list of people before me is just amazing. I can't believe that I'm actually one of the people that you've chosen to speak with. I've done a few belly flops in my day, so if it happens tonight, you've all seen. It's hard to believe that Marty and Bill Carr and Dennis Rainbow pulled the Mustang Club together 5 years ago. That it's what I see tonight is what we did 5 years ago, pulling all those meetings together. My daughter Elizabeth. I'd like to congratulate the scholarship winners tonight. I know it took a lot to achieve what you've done. Mustang Pride to me, it goes with you forever. I take it wherever I go today. I hope that each one of you award winners have the opportunities and the challenges and the fun that I had in my while I go. You can only be as lucky as me to have that opportunity. As a freshman playing football, I went up to my friends and said, "What are you doing as a winter sport?" And I said, "I'm going to dive." Well, they say dive. Most of these kids didn't even know there was a pool in Medford High. As it turned out, I excelled in diving. I had a decision to make my junior year. The reason why I had to make the decision is because my sophomore year, I was second in the state, and they really wanted me to dive full time. So I had to decide whether to continue to play football or just dive. Well, I decided to do diving full time, and this turned out to be the best thing that I could possibly have done. I went on to win the state championship. I smashed the state championship record. I actually went on to win the New England Springboard Diving Championship at Brown University my senior year. And to rub salt in the wound, my teammates as football players went on to win the Super Bowl. So I got to enjoy both ends of it. Winning the titles didn't come easy. I dove almost every morning between 7 and 7:45. I mean, they said 6 o'clock, but I don't think Dick was ever there at 6 o'clock. but he was there at 7 in the morning. I mean, he gave up his mornings, and he showed up at 7, and I would show up, and probably every morning I would go show up. Dick would be there waiting for me to come into the pool. I'd dive in the morning, and then after school it would come, I'd go right to the swimming pool, and I'd dive some more. I'd dive with the team, and then I'd go home and my mother or my father, or when I got my license, I'd go off and I'd drive off to Harvard University, which had the best coach in the area, and I dove in Harvard for 2 hours at night. So a lot of hard work went into what I actually ended up accomplishing. I can remember this one particular morning. I showed up at 7 a.m. to dive. Dick Lennon was a little pissed at me because I decided I wasn't going to dive this morning. Well, before I get into that, I got to tell you a little story. See, my mother has 7 kids. And see, my mother would, instead of, whenever she did the laundry, she had this sock drawer off the kitchen. Well, this sock drawer was, she threw the laundry, instead of putting them together into socks and put them in everybody's bedroom, she put them in the sock drawer. Well, the sock drawer was off the kitchen. We had this little drawer, it wasn't little, it was the biggest drawer in the kitchen, but it was off to the side.
Well, as my brothers and sisters went off to college, and my brother Danny started swimming, the sock drawer became the sock drawer and the bathing suit drawer. Well, hell, the bathing suits were the size of socks. Well, this one particular morning with Dick Leonard, I wake up in the morning, 6:30 in the morning, I go over to the sock drawer, I grab my bathing suit, I throw it in the duffel bag, I run off to school, I get to school, and Dick opens the locker room, I go into the locker room, I get in the locker room and get totally undressed, I reach in the duffel bag, and I pull out my sister's red underwear. Needless to say, I did not dive that one particular one. True story. Having to make choices to attend college wasn't very difficult. I thought it would be. My junior senior year, I received letters from every school in the country, and as the letters came in, everybody trying to get you to go to that particular school. In this particular case, when Indiana flew me to Indiana, the most beautiful campus I had been to, and after traveling to all of them through diving, it's just absolutely fabulous. The coach says, now you're 18 years old, he says, you get a home and away sweat. Well, you guys are in high school, you know, sweats are, you know, it's a big deal. You get a home and away Indiana sweat, you get 5 bathing suits, we have our own weight room, we have 3 swimming pools, 3 diving pools at Indiana. We have unlimited tutors, we have training table, it goes on and on and on. We won 17 Big Ten championships. We've won 7 consecutive national championships. And the last thing he says, and we fly to meets, we don't take buses. I'm off to Indiana, I can't wait. My first practice in Indiana, I actually thought it was my last practice. I look around and I have 5 high school All-Americans and 2 Olympians, one from Denmark and one from Austria, all vying for 3 positions. You know, you're frustrated, you say, these guys are as good as me, and most of them are better than me, and I'm saying, how am I ever gonna make it? To top it all off, at the end of the first practice, the coach calls me over and he says, Andy, 3 things to make you successful here at Indiana. The first thing is, you weigh 150 pounds. I don't weigh that today. I want you to dive at 135, so you need to go on a diet. Well, a diet? What the hell is a diet? I had no idea what a diet was. The second thing he says to me is, that bathing suit you're wearing. Now, I still have my blue and white on, okay? He says, that bathing suit you're wearing, you need to get a bathing suit that's 5 sizes smaller than the one you wear on right now. I'm looking, and my bathing suit is about this wide. Okay, it's about that wide on the side. So I say, I gotta go to a bathing suit 5 sizes smaller. So picture me in the dressing room. I'm in the dressing room, and I try this bathing suit on. I might as well have had my sister's underwear on. It's pretty amazing. By the time I graduated, the bathing suit was about a half an inch wide. They were providing it, I had to wear it, so I was gonna do anything they told me to do. The third thing he says to me, which was the dagger in the heart, was he said, second semester, I have enrolled you in a ballet class. So now you can picture me in a leotard, doing pliés with the whole Indiana football team. That's a true story. Now you know why Indiana can't win football games. About my second week at IU, the seniors on the team, we had some unbelievable talent on the team, but the seniors on the team decided they're gonna take the freshmen out to initiate them. So they take us out to the Indiana quarries. The Indiana quarries are just like, I guess, our Quincy quarries, or I don't know if any of you have seen the movie Breaking Away. That movie is where they go out and dive against the cutters. Today, they say to me, Andy, we're gonna jump from 77 feet. Well, 77 feet, I'm sitting there, I'm saying, I'm a freshman, okay, you're taking me from 1 meter at Medford High, I go to Indiana, now I have to learn how to dive 3 meter, which is 10 feet high, and 10 meter, which is 33 feet high. Now you want me to jump from 77 feet? 77 feet's way up there. They hand you they hand me a set of rocks, and they say, throw the rocks, and when they hit the water, jump. Well, you throw the rocks, but I kept throwing rocks for about an hour. It just kept going. I still, to this day, wake up thinking I have to jump from that height. It's up there. Indiana had some unbelievable talent on this team. We had the only diver to beat Greg Louganis on 1 meter at Nationals. And that's what I had to compete against every day. This kid was amazing. He was the world trampoline champion, Rob Bollinger out of Illinois. And he was fun to watch every day. And I could beat him in the practice, but I couldn't beat him in a meeting. We had Danish and Austrian diving champs. So these guys represented their country at the Olympics. So, you know, they're getting treatment from home and money from home to be diving at Indiana. So it's, you know, you kind of feel lucky when you know, my biggest competition was at practice every day. I had a lot of fun on being on this team. I mean, we had three Big Ten championship teams. We had two NCAA championship diving teams where they combined our points that we scored when they were out there. We had nine kids on the team, so when we went to a meet, it was a pretty awesome sight seeing nine divers show up to dive, and all nine of us can compete, which was fascinating. 1 meet that I went to in Minnesota, we placed 1 through 5 on the 1 meter. You know, Indiana, it showed you the talent that I was chasing every day. There were plenty of days that I thought I should hang it up, but I never quit, and I struggled for every bit of playing time that I could get. I enjoyed every bit of it. I got to see most of the country because of it. Indiana would fly us to dual meets or fly us to a big meet or take, you know, pretty much we trained someplace warm every year, and it was totally at their expense, so I enjoyed that, all that end of it. When I finished at IU, I threw away the bathing suit and I put on a three-piece suit. I went into printing. Now, I knew nothing about printing. All I knew about printing was that ink came out of a pen. And my boss at the time, Paul, you're gonna laugh at this, he hands me the box of business cards and he says, here you go, your name's on it, go ahead, everybody, there's Boston, everybody needs printing. Well, I found out pretty quick that not everybody needed printing. After 4 or 5 months, I realized that printing, I better either do something quickly or I'm out of a job. What happened was I landed the AT&T account a month before they split up with New England Telephone, and I couldn't sell them printing fast enough. It was every day, as much as I possibly could. From that base of business and book of business, I went on and created a larger base that I ultimately have today. And I decided that 10 years ago, I had to do something on my own. I started Mass Printing and Forms. Mass Printing and Forms is a $5 million printing company. I have 13 employees, and I have no idea where I'm going with it, except it's going great guns, and I can't wait. I enjoy every day of it. Diving has been a great sport. There's nobody to blame but yourself. When you're on a diving board and you make a mistake, it's you. It's not the coach. It's not anybody else. It's, you're on your own. So you have to sink or swim on your own merits. You learn to believe in yourself right away. And that's something that I do every day, is that I believe in what I do every day. I think I'm the best printing salesman there is. And I think that all comes from what I did in diving. Because of diving, I am as successful as I am today in my personal and professional life. I've had a lot of luck, though. I've had some people to support me. My parents, who never missed a meet in high school ever. My wife, who's been with me for every career move. I got to see the last 2 years at Indiana, so she can tell me I did do plenty of belly flops. And my three kids, Elizabeth, Emily, and Andrew, who I'm chasing from field to field, and swimming pool, to basketball court, to soccer field, to you name it. I appreciate you guys having me speak tonight. Hopefully you got something out of me. And I really appreciate the Mustang Club and what they've done for everybody here. Good luck.
We do have a plaque here for Andy. In grateful appreciation for honoring us by your presence and being our guest speaker, May 24th, 2000, the Mustang Club of Medford. chairperson for the presentation of the scholarships, Mr. Bill Carr.
Good evening. I just want to thank the committee, Carlson Cardi, Mark Smith, and Ed Nolan, who helped us in the selection of these candidates. The thing is, it's one that expressed pride in Medford. You didn't have to be an outstanding student. It was one that showed the spirit that we're looking for. And we raised all this money, as it was mentioned before, at the comedy night and whatever other way we can. So we're going to be looking for members, and we've set a record. We've gone 4 years and no one new from this place has joined, seems like that. Anyhow, the night when we come, please tomorrow morning call us and join for next year. We need your support. Thank you. Now, I'll introduce the coaches and they can come up and talk about their candidate. Kelly Driscoll, would you please come forward and say something about Sean Westbrook?
Thank you very much, Billy, and ladies and gentlemen. Joe, thank you for writing my speech again to me tonight. Joe Brandy usually condenses it to about 32 seconds. But to kind of describe the young man is going to get an award that I'm privileged to present tonight, let me paint a scenario for you. He's a senior at Medford High. You know, every senior wants to go out with kind of a bang, whether you're a hockey player or a diving champion or cheerleader or whatever. This guy can walk in and see the year first thing he's greeted with is, oh, by the way, your team was so bad last year that you can't go to the state tournament, even though all the guys are coming back had nothing to do with the problems. And two, you're going to be very young, and the league's going to be very good, and you're probably going to get your butts kicked. But, geez, we'd love to have you play hockey first. So, this kid's intelligent. I know the high school scenario today. A lot of things you can do besides, you know, going to a cold rink every night, practicing, playing, and only winning four games, losing 10 one-goal games. And lastly, he got an award for loyalty. And that's probably the best way to describe this young man. His loyalty. Was he, you know, NHL material in the future? I don't know. Is he going to be BC, BU? You know, Hockey East, ECAC, superstar? I don't think so. Is he a good kid? Great kid. Is he a loyal kid? Super kid. Is he a good student? Fantastic. Great parents? Absolutely. Put him in the right direction, bet your life. Norwich University next year? Great future ahead of him. I suspect, as I said last week, this guy's going to be a politician or a lawyer. Sean Westwood.
Mustang Club scholarships. We, the coaching staff, we do have a staff now, we're not surprised. Tammy epitomizes Mustang spirit. She loves being a Mustang, cheering her heart out for the football and basketball teams and putting her best foot forward on the competition mat. Tammy came to us as a freshman from Pop Warner football. That's right, football. Sorry, Coach Baldini, but you lost a great addition to your team. No one worked harder than Tammy. She knew to keep her spot, she always had to improve her skills, and that only propelled her to push the envelope further. If we said, Tammy, you'll never do that, that would be all she'd need, because she'd do it. even if it was just to prove us wrong. In her role as captain this year, her drive and dedication served as a model for the underclassmen. Tammy played every role on our team. She was a base, a flyer, a tumbler, and an excellent dancer. She was a strong base, but we came to her last year and told her we needed her flexibility and she'd have to learn to fly and twist out of an opening stunt sequence. She worked and worked on it, and her ground-up scorpion to heel stretch to scale was one of the prettiest we had on our team. Having injured her ankle numerous times, Tammy often shared in pain, but that never stopped her from performing to the very best of her ability. She was a worker, no question about it. Tammy always tried to make everyone feel comfortable on the team. That meant knowing the material. She was the one who'd teach the new girls the cheers, or go over and over the dance for the new team members who just couldn't get our choreographer's intricate moves. In her spare time, Tammy, like the rest of the team, has done numerous hours of community service, helping with the holiday celebration, feeding the elderly at the annual senior citizen picnic, and helping the Kiwanis Club with their jail day fundraiser. In addition to that, Tammy loves helping with the emotionally and physically challenged students at Medford High School. She has that special something which will serve her well in her chosen field of nursing. Tammy's accomplished a lot over the years in Sharon. She's taken home the most spirited trophy, the Verity Collin Memorial Scholarship Award. She was a member of the 1998 state and national championship team. She was selected an NCAA All-American cheerleader. She was selected the best cheerleader on our team during a competition and received an application to be a summer camp counselor. More importantly though, Tammy learned how to be a good loser as well as a good winner. You cannot always win. It's hard, but it's life. She was a fierce competitor, but she was always the first one on our team to congratulate those on the winning team. Losing only made Tammy work harder and pushed the team to do the same. That is a true example of Mustang spirit. Her work ethic will be missed next year. Tammy, I hope you left it with one of the underclassmen. In closing, I am proud that Tammy is representing the cheerleading program tonight. She is the type of person who changes your life by being a part of it. She has made us laugh and made us believe that there is good in high school students today. When you are down, she will do everything in her power to try and brighten your day. She has grown from an insecure freshman into quite a powerhouse for our team. It has been a privilege to coach her. Mark and Marie, Sharon has never been an easy road, but I'm glad we've taken it together. We've had some real good times. You should be very proud of her accomplishments, but most of all, I know that you're most proud of the fabulous young lady that she has become. Tammy, keep smiling and working hard, and there'll be no mountain you can't climb. You deserve the very best in life. Good luck at Curry College in nursing. Congratulations.
Been an honor and a privilege. He is one of those young men that will show up to your practices day in and day out and truly make you laugh and truly make you want to be a coach and be there day in and day out. I've gotten to know his mom a little bit, and I know she's very proud of each other, and that's very honorable to have your parents very proud of you. Okay? I wish him all the luck in the world next year at UMass Dartmouth. If he can only bring half the spirit, charm, and dedication that he gave me as a captain and as an athlete, he's going to do a lot of great things at UMass Dartmouth. I'm very proud to give this award to Charlie Hartnett. And the only word of advice I can give you is to hand that check over to your mother right away. Because that $500 at UMass Dartmouth may go awry unless you put it towards your books. So please welcome Charlie Hartnett up. He's a great guy.
Hurdler. He's one of the toughest players and hottest hitters I've ever coached. This display is statement, if you read that, it talks about the dedication and importance of being a Mustang, which is what this award is all about. He was recruited by WPR, RPI, Tufts, several other academic schools. He's decided to go down to South Carolina and attend Clemson University to study engineering this fall. We wish him all luck in the world. Steve Chaussette.
While he was ill, that I would try to make sure that people did not forget about him. And if anyone who ever knew him could not ever forget about him, but this award is one way I've chosen to keep that promise that I had made to him. He loved his children and their friends, and it's important that you know that he was just a regular good person who went out of his way to help others. He'd do small things and big things, and any quiet effort he thought would help to make sure things went more easily for other people. Just like all of us should do. I know he'd be very proud of the students who would receive this scholarship, a scholarship which it may just simply help to buy a semester's worth of books, but that little help will hopefully mean something to you. Each student who applied had something very touching to say, and as always, and as I've said in the last 2 years, it's unfortunate that every senior cannot receive some recognition. In fact, many of the students here tonight undoubtedly had a conflict this evening. My own senior girl, Amy, and most of the students here also were recognized for various things at the high school, but they managed to get them back here in time to do both, so that's great. I'm pleased to present the two Michael Patterson Awards this year to a lovely young lady, Susan Kyle, and a terrific young man, Chris Dobbins. Susan wrote in her application that it's not necessarily winning that makes the effort worthwhile. It's the participation and the involvement. Those words impressed me because Michael was very much like that. He'd persist until he achieved the best possible outcome in any given endeavor, and Susan is exactly right. It's trying, not winning, that ultimately comes the most. Chris wrote about how very much being a student athlete at Medford High meant to him, and that he hoped to go on to a successful and joyful life. That's really important, that second part. Life should be lived happily and joyfully, and without being overly sentimental here, it really does not hold any guarantees, and life can be very short. And that really impressed me that you said that, Chris. That's why each day we should just try our best to do our best and try to live as happily as we possibly can, despite any challenges we may face. I'm happy to introduce the coaches of Susan and Chris and wish each student here tonight much success next year in the college you will attend. Thank you.
Good
evening, everyone. First of all, I'd like to say thank you to the Mustang Club and all the members, invited guests, Mr. Kelly, athletic director, as well as the Patterson family. This is truly a great pleasure for me to be able to give this award. Tonight's recipient, obviously, is Susan Cobb. She shows a constant willingness to learn and teach, and works well with others and has a remarkable work ethic. She makes thoughtful choices of her life and chooses her own values. She really knows where she wants to go in life. She has achieved several personal and academic awards at Medford High School. Naming a few, she's ranked 11th in her class. She's received highest honors achievement awards in math, psychology, English, the language arts. Her extracurricular activities are very impressive as well.
She's a member of the National Honor Society, the Key Club, the Student Government, yearbook staff. She was one of the chairpersons for the Junior Marshall. She's a chairperson of the Senior Strut fundraiser. She's a Junior Marshall, volunteered work for various health blocks and cleanup stays in Medford. Being a lacrosse player for me for 3 years was very difficult. She knows that winning isn't everything because in 3 years we haven't won a game yet. She is truly a very unique individual where she tries to teach everybody something new on the field. It's very hard to be a co-captain and trying to keep everybody on the same page, as well as myself and Coach Glusi. We're going to get there someday, and she's proven to us that we will get there. She was elected for a Central League All-Star last year. She was nominated again this year, which has been voted on through the league. She's well-respected between her peers, her teachers, her coaches. And to quote from her, a combination of integrity, dedication, and respect makes her an outstanding person in the community. I wish her the best of luck. She's attending Tufts University next year. It's my privilege and pleasure to present this year's Fast Memorial Scholarship Award to Susan Cowell.
I want to thank everyone. everyone for coming this evening. I think it was a wonderful time, but I do want to say one thing before we adjourn. This banquet would not be possible without Mark Smith, and I think we should give him a great hand.
Thank you all. We'll see you next year. Thank you.